And welcome to the Schaefer Center here on the campus of Southwestern Assemblies of God University here in Waxahachie, Texas, where today the Lady Lions host the Texas Wesleyan University Lady Rams, coming up next right here on the SAGU Sports Network. Everybody, he's Tim Roberts. I'm Rob Price. Tyler Evans joins in just a second. Tim, Lady Lions come into this season game, this game of the season, 11-12 overall, 5-8 in conference play. Meanwhile, their opponent, Lady Rams, 11-11, 6-7 overall. Both teams have reached 6-7 overall. Both teams had that final third, 13 games behind, 7 games left. So if you're a screenwriter, which I know you like to write, we're in Act 3 of that conference season right now.
Lady Lions got a big Act 3 coming up after today. Out of the remaining 6 games, 3 of those are going to come against top-ranked opponents. Teams going to be very hard to beat. So if they want a legitimate shot to end this season on a winning streak, of winning 4 out of the last 7, it starts today. You got to find a way to win this one.
Lions are in 8th place, or actually one game behind, tied for 8th place, I should say. Lady Rams are in 6th, so just a few games separate those bottom-tier teams, Tim. Last 2 nights ago, lost a tough one up in Chickasha, Oklahoma. Talk about that one. The close on a 9-0 run, that one, 65-63, did the Drovers.
Yeah, the Lady Lions played well the entire game. Very efficient offensively the first 33 minutes. Closed off the last 5 minutes scoreless, however. Committed 7 turnovers in the last 7 minutes. That's just average of 1 a minute. Last second shot by Nia Winston fell just short. Just a very tough loss after they led the majority of the game. They led to the first... And then found a way to lose it in the last minute.
Drovers were just 6 of 30, Tim, from inside the arc, you know, from normal two-point shots. But beyond the arc, a completely different story. 15 of 39, doubling their average. They average about 7 threes per game. That's 21 extra points that this team really doesn't score from that part of its game. You give up that kind of scoring in this conference, you're going to lose almost every time. Looking at this Lady Rams team, Tim, Lady Rams crushed Northwood just 2 nights ago, 88-54, their second win in a row after dropping 3 straight, 2 of which were an anomaly in the schedule.
Yeah, they had to play number 5 Oklahoma Baptist in back-to-back games due to some bad weather back in early December. They lost the first one by 12, but then game came just this close to upsetting OBU, again, the number 5 team in the nation, just 4 days later falling 58-56. Against ranked teams this season, they have 1 win against then number 22 Wiley, 74-69. They almost beat number 25 LSU Shreveport on this very court back during the SAGU Classic back in November of 2013.
A long time ago.
Last year, basically, they lost again by 2 points. So this is a team that has hung with some of the best in the nation all year long.
Rams have 3 games of their 6 remaining games after today against ranked opponents. So this is a, you hate to use the word must win over, you know, overuse it, but it is a must win for the Rams. They want to stay out of the race for that 8th place spot, the final spot in the Sooner. Look at the series between these 2 games. All time, 17-10 in favor of the Rams, including a 6-game winning streak dating back several years when these 2 teams tangled all the time in the Red River.
Well, yeah, they're old Red River Conference foes. They switched to the Sooner Athletic Conference at the exact same time, so they stay conference foes. Looking at some stats for Lady Rams, though, you see on paper, this team looks a lot better than their under 500 at record would seem to indicate. They're number 3 in the nation in blocks per game, averaging over 5 a game. They're number 8 in field goal percentage, averaging over 47% shooting. They're number 10 in field goal percent defense, holding opponents to 35% shooting. Number 10 assists per game with 16.6. The one real wrinkle to all those stats, though, they have a negative 3.8 turnover margin. That's kind of been a real bit, kind of a chink in their armor all year long. That's kind of put them on the wrong side of those of those games occasionally. Look at the stats, though. They are much better than their record indicates.
Yeah, they average 69 points a game, give up 67. Meanwhile, for SAGU, they're third in the Sooner in defense, allowing just 60.5 a game, but they're first in the Sooner in percentage defense, field goal 34.4. So nationally, though, there's some pretty good numbers for the Lady Lions. Number three in the nation in field goal defense at that 34.4 mark. Number eight in steals at 12.8 a game. 29 in the nation in turnovers. It's a plus 1.8 margin. And then the average 61.7 points a game, allows 6.5. So besides the fact that SAGU has a reputation for being stingy, Tim, what do all these stats tell us for today's game against this really familiar opponent?
Well, the Lady Rams dropped 80 points on SAGU the first time these two teams met. That's the most points the Lady Lions have allowed in any game this season. So Lady Rams were able to solve this defense last time. We'll see if they can do it again today.
Let's talk about that last game back on January 9th. What happened in that 80-point barrage?
Well, yeah, the Lady Rams won 80-59, and they rode a 31-11 second-half run to turn what was a competition into just a blowout. They ran off with it the second half. It was over with about 10 minutes left to go. And they had four players in double figures, led by Amy Moody's 22 points. Taylor Hill scored 18 for the Lady Lions, leading their way in scoring on that night.
As we talked a moment ago, this is a team that left the Red River last year along with SAGU, now joining the Sooner. They know each other very well. That usually gives a little advantage, in my opinion, to the team that just lost the previous game because of the small tendencies you pick up literally on the court playing. So it's more among the players, the little tendencies you pick up and how someone rubs, how they pick and roll. So to me, if there's any advantage, the Lions might be able to learn from that loss last time.
It's always easier to learn from a loss than a win.
Sure.
And of course, some of the players are going to try to get the Lady Rams to get another win. It's going to be Toisha Cooper. She leads the team with 11.5 points per game and 7 rebounds a game. Also averages about a block a game, so she's a part of that top-rated blocking defense in the NAIA. Amy Moody leads the team with 5.1 assists a game. That's number 10 in the NAIA. She also has 2.4 steals a game, which is number 25 in the NAIA. She's just a big utility player right there. Also averages about 10 points a game. Lastly, Chrissy Parker. She's 6'3". She leads the team with about a block and a half a game. Just a monster presence inside, and she's going to try to find a way to torment Taylor Hill and Nia Winston tonight.
She may do that just indeed. For the Lady Lions, Jara Rodriguez, let's start with her. She is 7-2, the team is, when she scores in double figures, averaging 7.9 a game right now. She's bumped up to 10, maybe get you a win tonight. Number two, look at Taylor Hill. We've mentioned her name all season long. Season high 19 points on Thursday. She averages over 11 points a game over the last 5 games. And then Lakin Ward leads the team, a newcomer to the team, leads the team in rebounds, 6.6 a game, has got to help limit Wesleyan's second chance opportunity. So quick break, be back in a minute with the anthem, stars, and tip-off right here on the SAGU Sports Network.
And welcome inside the Shake Center. We have used time for tip-off between the Lady Rams and Lady Lions.
Nia Winston will control the tip for Lady Lions. We're underway. And a big matchup here as we enter that bottom third of the season. Lady Rams one game ahead of Lady Lions in the standings in the Sooner. Nia works the first possession over to McAfee. She'll drive into the lane. Stops, releases, rolls off the front edge of the rim, and Lady Rams will cycle it back for their first possession. There's a shot from the outside, a three-point shot. No good from Moody, Amy Moody. And saved by Winston.
That's one of those times you just might want to let it go. She found a way to corral it in.
Here's Hill, the sophomore from Wasatchee High. Winston's going to try a three. She nails it. Nia Winston gets the ball rolling for the Lady Lions.
She has really elevated her distance shot in this season. She's always been very, very strong on the inside, being able to drive with that speed. But she has elevated her three-point game into a new level. And that's what's made her the leading scorer in the Sooner Athletic Conference at this point in the season.
Pass inside. That was handy trying to connect with Chrissy Parker, but we'll keep it right here with just 10 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Handy will inbound over the bowl. 3-point shot from the corner. It's going to be short, high rebound. And again, it's Winston as she straddles the baseline or the edge of the out-of-bounds line.
And avoids the travel. So Lady Lions doing a good job limiting second opportunities for the first two shots.
McAfee getting the start today. Into the paint again. Pops over to Ed Roberts. Robert missed that one from the baseline. Shakita Roberts, a senior from San Antonio. One of the leading shot blockers in the nation. And McAfee clears it for Hill.
Just good defense inside by Charity Page, forcing the errant shot.
Lady Rams show man-to-man coming out to begin this ball game. Another three-point bomb from Winston, and a whistle as the ball was in the air.
Hit the shot clock. Dead ball as soon as that happens. So both teams exchanging some missed shots here early on, trying to find their stroke. And here's Lady Lions after giving up 80 to the Rams earlier this season. Definitely would like to play a much lower scoring game, a game that you have a chance of winning. A travel.
Travel call on Liz Handy. She's from the area, from Arlington, a transfer from Panola Junior College, just a junior. She'll be back next year for head coach Bill Franey in his third year for the Lady Rams. As they hail from just up the road in Fort Worth. An old foe returns to the Schaefer Center, Tim.
Well, it's not, they never left.
They never left.
We just took lockstep out of the Red River Conference into the SAGU Athletic Conference, and the battle of 287 stays intact.
Winston, a 15-footer, good, swishes it, and she's got all 5 points for the Lady Lions in the first 3 minutes of play. 5-0 Lady Lions. Moody cycles it over to Cooper. Looking inside the bowl and stolen away from Roberts. Winston, she already has 5. Eyes the basket over to Hill. Now McAfee swings it back to Winston. She looked inside for Charity Page a minute ago. A moment. Now Page trying for position against bowl.
It's going to be a foul called underneath the basket. It's going to be against Caitlin Bolt. First foul of the game. The Lions will keep possession.
Bowles is a junior from Albuquerque, New Mexico, from the Air Force Academy.
And a timeout called by Texas Wesleyan after they go over 3.5 minutes, 16-17 remaining on the clock. They've yet to score. Had some opportunities, just missed them. They've also had a turnover, so trying to find their footing early on. They come off of just a demolition of Northwood on Thursday night, rolling 88-54. As you mentioned, they were on a 3-game losing streak before that with back-to-back losses to Oklahoma Baptist and a loss to Mid-America. Not easy opponents, to say the least. But now they're rematched against the Lady Lions, a team they beat by 21 points. And honestly, it wasn't even that close. Lady Lions went on about a 6 or 7-0 run to end the game off. It could have been 30.
Back into play. That's Winston short this time. Page almost tipped it out to her teammate, but here comes Texas Wesleyan, yet to score in this ballgame. 4 minutes in, inside the bowl. She's double-teamed by Page and Roberts. Long three, off the mark, and a long rebound. Missed by Handy and handled by Lady Lions. Now here's Winston on the move, off the glass. Hit the side of the backboard. Now in transition. An errant shot, and TWU still yet to get on the scoreboard.
And that's part of the strategy of a Coach Beatles defense. They'll let you take threes. They'll let you shoot from the outside. Right. They want to trap you inside. That does hurt you on the occasional night like we saw on Thursday, where Science and Arts just shot out of their minds, hit 15 three-pointers, and turn the game around. But in general, he's just going to rely on the fact that you won't shoot that well.
Hill drives strong to the basket. No fear in her eyes.
Almost got her own rebound, but just lost control. And Amy Moody brings it down the court.
Here's Tayshia Cooper. Skips over to Moody. Inside the bowl. And rejected.
Blocked by Roberts.
Winston across the timeline. She's got all the points in this ball game. Now here's a steal and a fast break. And Roberts just tackles, if I could use that word, Tawisha Cooper. McAfee tackles Tawisha Cooper.
But that's not going to be a foul, although it will be a foul called in actually now.
A gain of 5 yards, call it third down.
Just tried to cut inside and knock the ball away. Prevents the easy layup, though. And we are still, by the Lady Rams still, are scoreless.
There's a shot from the side. Nice hustle rebound from Nolisa. Just came in the game. On Yesenim Nolisa with a long rebound keeps the possession alive for Texas Wesleyan. And a travel called, Tim. That's two now on the Rams early on. That one against Moody.
They are just not really finding their footing at this point. Struggling early on.
Well, honestly, but for two shots from Winston, we could say the same for the Lions, but they at least got some points on the board. Nearly 6 minutes in, and a turnover, a bad pass from Hill to Winston, although Winston's raising her hand, taking credit for the turnover, but looked like it was more Hill, just led Winston too much.
Lady Lions, you've missed some big opportunities here. Another turnover against the Lady Rams. Just dribbled off of Melissa's hands. Went out of bounds. But if you're Lady Lions, you've now held the Lady Rams scoreless for the first 6 minutes of this game, and you have a paltry 5-0.
And it's just a simple 2-3 defense. They're not really trapping or anything. They're just playing solid interior defense. Behind the back pass to Page from Winston. Not a good shot, but offensive board and ripples over the rim. Lady Lions up 7-0.
Good follow through by Roberts. Just blocks out, uses the length of her arms to get the advantage.
And now here comes the trap, Tim. Excuse me. Now here comes a trap from the Lady Lions.
And another travel. Three travels and a turnover here in the last few minutes. And for the Lady Rams, a team that depends on their offensive strengths, they are finding absolutely no momentum right now. 6.5 minutes into this one, they are still scoreless.
Hill spins back around to Winston. She looks at the three, spots up, and drains it.
Spots up.
Nia Winston, her second three of the game. Lions up 10-0. Winston has eight.
Lady Lions starting to open up a little bit on offense now. This is what you want to do when you've got a team that's struggling early on. Foul underneath. And this may result in free throws, and it will. A chance for the Lady Rams to get on the board. Lady Lions, though, good to finally see a little bit of an offensive burst after going 6 minutes, just leading by five, to go up by 10. You want to take advantage of that early.
Winston, one of the Sooner Athletic Conference's leading scorers.
No good from Nolisa. And the Lady Rams are still scoreless.
Elisa's free throw is good. Hits the back of the rim and falls in. So finally, the drought is over. Nearly 7 minutes into the ball game. Lady Rams finally on the board. Still no field goals yet, though. Here's Winston. She's got eight early. Inside pass to Page. Got position. Missed the shot, but she's fouled. She'll go to the line.
That's that. She had the position. As soon as she got underneath the basket, it was allow the layup or draw the foul for Nolisa.
She is going to be a great player for Coach Beatles. Just a freshman, stands 6 foot, hails from Nacogdoches, Texas, out in East Texas. Misses the first free throw. This is a player who's earned her spot as a starter as the season has progressed.
You can see right inside. Great communication with Winston. Misses both free throws, though. Second one rattles out. So the lead remains 9.
Here's that suffocating defense. McAfee all over the guards. Passing up the shot there was Briggs Scribner. Here's Moody for 3. Off the front of the rim, but an offensive board. Missed by Kayla McCray, who just checked into the game. Had a good look there to put that one in.
Had a good look, but the ball will go off the Lady Lions. So one of the big reasons they have not scored early on is they've had no second chance opportunities. Now they're getting a third chance on this possession to see if they can capitalize on it, try to get that first field goal.
Moody over to Cooper. Off the rim again. Tarisha Cooper, a senior, misses another shot from Wichita Falls, Texas. Hill spots up Winston. McAfee into the paint, skips over to Page. She drives strong into the glass, and she is hacked. She'll go back to the line. Missed her first two. She wants to try to atone for those misses. Just a moment ago, foul number 31. That's Kayla McCray. She's a transfer from Eastern New Mexico University, Tim, from Watauga, Texas.
0-for-3 from the line, though, to start this game out. Like seeing the aggression.
Strong move. I like that move.
Move inside, see your opportunity, and take it. 0-for-4 on free throws, though. Some big missed chances there. Don't want to leave points on the floor early on.
Not at all. This team could get hot any time, Lady Rams. They are staying one game ahead of these Lions in the standings, in sixth place alone right now.
Travel. Page forced that one. Staying in Amy Moody's face. Made her double think where she wanted to pass it to.
That's the third or fourth turnover right in front of the Lady Lions bench. Are they like whispering like all kinds of secret signals to them? What is going on here?
If you're near Lady Lions bench, it means you're in prime position to get trapped. And that's what Lady Lions defense loves to do, is trap you down low.
McAfee, nice shot. It just hangs forever and rolls out. Nice move into the paint. Wide open 10-foot jumper. It was halfway down, took a break, and decided to roll off back into the rim.
That looked for sure in, but we all know the inside of that rim can play tricks with a basketball.
Rejected by Roberts. One of the leading shot blockers in the nation, shows why she can stuff those stats in the block category.
That's her second block of the game, and that one was on a jumper. And I always love to see a shot block on a jumper much more than a layup. Layups are bound to get blocked. That takes patience and timing, no matter how tall you are.
And to not commit a foul as well. It's so easy, because usually it's a swipe motion, Tim, and it's so easy to get a foul called when your hand moves across.
McCray comes up with another offensive rebound. Lady Rams will stay on possession. Winston just steals it away.
Great, great 2-3 zone defense, collapsing on Scribner.
Yeah, read Scribner's pass perfectly, got a hand in front of it. If you're the Lady Rams, you might have to start buying shots here in a second, because they're not falling anyway.
Hill over to Winston. Lady Rams stay in that man-to-man. Hill, strong off the glass, a scramble for the ball. Cooper will come away with it. Her team down 10-1. In an off-balance shot, Hill trapped near the baseline, gets it out to Winston, and she's gonna see if she can make something happen in transition. Works right, long finger roll, nearly put it in. A lot of contact all over the place, no whistle though. Lady Rams across the timeline with just about 10 minutes left, halfway through the first half, 1 point.
No field goals. Absolutely amazing defense from Lady Lions right now. Just wish you could turn some more points.
That one was affected by Page. Now Rodriguez will get called for the foul on the weak side rebound from Nolisa, put her on the line. She has the Lady Rams' only point thus far.
If you're Lady Lions, you've missed some big opportunities here. Later on, as being uncharacteristically cold to start a game off.
Lisa sinks the first one. She's a transfer from Hofstra.
Here's some easy math for you.
Sure.
The Lady Rams are shooting 0% from the floor. I don't know how many shots they've taken, but that's some easy math for you. And you've held the team to 0% shooting over the first 10 minutes. You'd like to have larger than an 8-point lead. Well, it's 7 there. Just the benefit of the rim. Looked like it was going to be short for sure. So Lady Lions need to start making something happen on offense.
They need to make
here.
The free throws. With them.
They've missed 4 free throws, missed some easy shots.
And now a steal. It's Cooper. She has to get past Hill. Hill is able to distract the shot, but will send Cooper to the charity stripe. The chance to cut the lead to 5 without a single field goal in more than 10 minutes of play. I'm not sure that's a compliment or a caution.
Well, here's the thing. The Lady Lions have now been held scoreless over the last 4-plus minutes. They led this game 10-0 before the Lady Rams had even had a point, which they got around 14 minutes.
Here's Hill. She just had to stop Cooper.
It's good. Yeah. Make a play on the ball and affect the shot enough that they don't have a shot at the three-point play.
Sure.
First shot was no good from Cooper.
Tawisha Cooper.
Second is also no good, so I don't know what's in that ball right now, but it's not falling for either team.
Brittany Griffin has checked into the game for Coach Beatles. Winston for three. Off the mark, long rebound, corralled in by Chrissy Parker. A transfer from Norfolk State University in Virginia.
Another foul down.
And Rodriguez can't believe it.
Yeah, try to make a play on the ball. Looks like she got a hand on the arm during the pass, though. That's her second foul. Into the game will come Croc. Nia Winston will head to the bench. Quick inside.
Shot.
And it just won't go.
Wow.
And if you are the Lady Rams, you've just got to wonder what is wrong.
Rodriguez nearly traveled, gets it over to Croc. Misses the 15-footer.
Also into the game right now is Brittany Griffin. She's in for Charity Page.
Wide open shot from the baseline. Off again. Cooper. Cooper is the third leading scorer in this ball club. So he'll averages 11.6 a game. Nothing yet from the field.
Lady Lions on top by seven. They've been held scoreless for nearly 6 minutes. Lady Rams have not hit a field goal yet.
Lefty off the left side of the glass. Brittany Griffin off the bench.
Just a nice drive inside. Laying it off the glass perfectly. Brittany Griffin. Don't you see her this early into the game? Coach Beatles made a good move early on. Get her some playing time.
Probably had a great week of practice. Earned some minutes early and taking advantage of that.
And that pass just sails out of the back. And there's a timeout on the floor to be a full timeout. So let's go to a quick commercial break. All right, welcome back to the Shape Center. We apologize. We're having some technical difficulties here with the technology. At the moment, the Lady Lions lead 23-10. Lady Rams got their first field goal at 7:33 to go in the half. At the line right now, shot is good. So as we do apologize for the missed timing there. When we last left, the score was 12-3, and the Lady Lions are now on top 23-11 with 2:41 left to play in the half. Second free throw is no good. Taylor Hill rebounds.
After Nolisa's first field goal at 7:33, the only two other field goals, Tim, are from McCray for Texas Wesleyan at 5:28 left, and then at 4:37 left. So Lions find themselves up, and it's all said and done. They're up by 12 and playing really good defense.
Playing some great defense. We saw some great steals inside. McAfee with an amazing steal going coast to coast with a clutch layup. That would put the Lady Lions up 23-8. Blocked inside by Roberts. Just rejected. Down the floor comes Hill. Into McAfee. Can't lay it up, but Roberts with a putback. Can't put it in. And that's just been a problem for the Lady Lions all year long, hitting their layups. And it rears its ugly head twice in about 1.3 seconds after an amazing block by Roberts, her third block of the half.
Nice board from Page. I sense anger in her face. Charity Page ripped it out of the air.
So far, the Lady Lions defense has just been unassailable.
Hill tried to zip it over the head of her defender into Page, and the defender just took a step back, reached her hand up, and took it right out of the air. Here come the Lady Rams. Moody over to Handy. Weak side rebound. McCray, but a whistle as the shot was going in. They're going to count it.
Yep. Count the bucket. Chance for a three-point play.
McCray will go to the line.
By 31, Caleb McCray.
It's her third field goal of the game.
running away with the leading scorer honors for the Lady Rams right now. It's been a tough half, but they have put it together somewhat after just 3 points in the first 13 minutes. Finding some offense. Still, as we approached 1 minute left in the half, 13 points for a team that scored 80 against the Lady Lions last time, the most they gave up on the year.
Cox fouled as she was fading away, trying to elude Chrissy Parker. There's not many folks that she needs to fade away from, but she may be one. Parker stands 6'3". Cassie Cox in her own right is 6'1", but she elects to take the ball low in the paint and then spin back. Here it is again. She gets great position here. It likes to fade away, but does draw the contact. Second free throw is good. Lions back up by 12. Nearing a 1 minute remaining in the first quarter. In the first half.
Lady Rams wish it was the first quarter with just 13 points on the board. They could use three more.
And it's going to be good.
Yeah, that's no Lisa. Just drawing the contact from behind, laying it in.
As one of the defenders just dragged her arm down. But Nolisa's strength, able to put the ball in the basket anyway, the free throw rattles in.
So they complete the three-point play, cut the lead down to nine. Finding their footing now a little bit. After 15 minutes of pure futility,
Roberts working hard inside the paint. Look at her work against Nolisa. Roberts gets the ball underneath, travels over to the left side, missed the layup. Now weak side rebound is up and in from Alexis McAfee. Nice overall interior play from the Lady Lions.
Just a nice shift to the right by McAfee, as you saw, switching places with Roberts, knowing where the rebound was going to be if it was a missed shot. That's going to be a foul on Roberts underneath. Matt Wilson, the Lady Rams to the line with 14.3 seconds remaining. To the line will go Kayla McCray. McCray with 6 points on the game, leading the Lady Rams.
Back in for SAGU, 35 Charity Page.
So after unbelievably poor shooting mixed with amazing defense, Lady Rams will still escape this half with obviously not a scoring total they want to see, but one that's not unbelievable. After not hitting a field goal for the first 12 and a half minutes, I think they've got to be very happy with 18 points at the half.
Winston spots up a three from the corner. It's going to be short. Rebound, Lady Rams. They've got half a second left. Good if it goes. It bounces harmlessly off the backboard. So we've reached halftime here at the Schaefer Center. Your score, 27-18, a 9-point lead. It was a 7-point lead with 7:33 left in the first half when the Rams got their first field goal. So they played almost a push from there. Take a quick break. Back with more stats and comments about this first half of play. You're watching SAGU Sports Live right here on the SAGU Sports Network.
Quick start here as Winston steals it away. Driving up, won't get it to go, and Roberts sort of tapping it back to herself to a couple of bounces.
McAfee looking for Page, swings it back over to Hill. Winston, she's got 10 in the first half already. McAfee back to Winston, 12 on the shot clock. Winston slides over to Hill. Now inside to Page, stripped in the block. That strip and foul is going to be on Toisha Cooper. Don't think she was in the act of shooting. Well, looks like she was in the act of shooting. She was. Nope. The referee is going to say
Two shots. Charity Page.
It's one of those flip of coins. Was she lifting the ball up above the waist to, you know, to positively make a shot attempt or not?
That was big, because that was with just 4 seconds left on the shot clock.
Right.
And that is going to be the fourth foul against Toisha Cooper. So she is in foul trouble to start this one off.
29-18. Lead back up to 11. Nice inside pass to Bowl. Pass came from Parker to Bowl. They finished off that nice bucket.
They had that opportunity a few times in the first half, and Bowl finally finishes it off with the layup.
Lady Rams stay in that man-to-man defense. They've been in that defense all game long, electing not to even try the zone against these Lady Lions. Hill goes into the paint, skips on the left side, rolls off the front of the rim. Here's Roberts, no foul. Page had a handle on it. We'll keep it right here. 25 left in the shot clock. Several Lions had a shot at that in the paint. McAfee, she's played well the first half. Gets back to Winston. Now 15 on the shot clock. Back to McAfee. And she's going to be whistled for a travel as she's trying to make a move to the paint.
Yeah, just a little bit too much movement on that one, trying to pass it around.
Now some of the stats that you see that are important for us to note here, Tim, in the first half.
Well, the big stat that stands out, obviously, after Wesleyan shooting percentage is SAGU's. They only shot 32% in the first half, and that's why after 13 minutes of defensive just shutout dominance, Lady Lions are only up by 9. A very precarious position against a solid Lady Rams team that you just can't imagine is going to shoot that poorly again, and they haven't so far here in the second half. So that coupled with a personal stat, and oh, just a foul over the back. That's going to come against, I believe you're going to call Chrissy Parker.
Five blocks in the first half for the Lions, none for the Lady Rams. Three blocks alone from Shakita Roberts.
That's what I was about to get to. That stat right there, just big time defense. Roberts anchoring them. And it travels. Roberts gets the rebound.
We shouldn't talk about her. We just jinxed her. What are we doing?
But yeah, overall on defense, Lady Lions, very solid. Roberts with three blocks. Taylor Hill, five rebounds. Five also for Roberts, two offensive, three defensive.
So just five field goals. So 10 points for the Lady Rams in the first half. The other 8 points off of field goals. Seven players scored for the Lady Lions in the first half as a whistle and a foul, a hoop and a harm. Go to the line will be Kayla McCray. Cuts the lead to 9. A free throw here will bring it back to 8.
As she cuts it to 7. Scoreboard here in the gym a little bit slow, but now it's 29-22.
No, check that.
Chance to make it 6. No good. And that was something else. Beyond their poor field goal shooting, the Lady Rams shot 57% from the line, 8-14. Left a lot of points there. Lady Lions shot 50%, 4-8. So both teams struggling from the free throw line. And in games like that, you want to be able to rely on that free throw shooting to get those points when you can't get them on the floor.
Winston shot no good. Page, the rebound, up and in. Strong move, leads with the right shoulder.
Yeah, going up against McCray right there. That was just a power move inside for Page.
Lady Rams out-rebounded the Lady Lions 27-20 in that first half as well. But like you said, a lot of missed shots, so they had a chance to get some. In fact, the offensive rebounds, 8-3 advantage for Texas Wesleyan. But you got to put them in. So you can have, hey, you know what? Have as many offensive boards as you want. Just don't put it in the basket.
First free throw is no good. Exactly. I mean, it's 8 offensive rebounds is good unless it comes just by pure statistical likelihood. Eventually, you're going to land, you're going to grab someone when you're that many misses.
0-9 from 3-point land. And we didn't really pick up that many shots beyond the arc, but they were just flying together so fast. And the statisticians tell us they took 9 shots beyond the arc.
Still unsuccessful.
Well, here we are now. 16:45 left. Lions up by 8. And now a steal from Texas Wesleyan, coast to coast.
And that's just great defense by Hill. Influences the shot, gets a hand on the ball, but doesn't draw the foul. Typically, when you face that situation, is send to the line for 2 or give up the layup. She said, I'll take the 3rd option, please. And a swish outside. That's Bowl. And that I believe is probably the first jumper we've seen from the Lady Rams. Oh, what a move by Winston.
High off the glass as she slid through the paint. Lead back to 8.
Big response on offenses. Lady Rams are starting to put it together now.
Bowl from the corner, looking for 2 in a row. Offensive rebound, no good. On up ahead to Winston. 1 against 2. Will she elect to go up it in? She does. Fighting for the rebound. Robertson lays it up and in. How about the glass work from Roberts?
Throws the fist bump right there as she was just pushed out of position. Found a way to muscle it through. And Roberts, a rejection. That's off of a pass, but it might as well have been a block.
Yep. That's what you got to do. Oh, you got to put that in, Taylor. But somehow the Lions come up with it. Winston, an 18-footer. Off the mark, chases down her own rebound outside the arc. You can see she smiles as she picks it up. We'll reset. Nice pass inside to Hill on that fast break. Hill unable to complete the fast break layup. But the Lions keep possession on some good glass work. That's Rodriguez now, too strong off the glass. Rams still down by 10.
They never trailed by any more than their largest deficit in the half was just, 15 points.
Roberts.
Say just, which is actually, it truly is a just 15 points when you shoot that poor to start the game. So the Ley Lions have done a good job of maintaining a double-digit lead for most of this game.
Roberts battling inside again. Look at the battle inside between Roberts and McCray. And a needless foul called on Winston as she was trying to reach in and pick the ball out of the pocket of Liz Handy beyond the three-point line. That's more of a frustration foul, Tim, when she missed a shot. So
she saw the opportunity to try to knock the ball away, but that is not a good foul because that is Winston's third foul. So with 14 and a half minutes to play, Lady Lions top scorer in some foul trouble. And a technical foul. We'll see who this is going to come against here. And by the way that they're walking back, looks like this is going to be on the Lady Lions, potentially. No, Winston's going to walk down the other end, so this is going to be against the Lady Rams, it looks like. Trying to see exactly what happened here. So after the three-point shot, maybe a little push or shove. Technical foul. See the replay here. And it must have just been words coming from Nolisa's mouth because there wasn't much contact. Looked like there was a little bit of contact made by Winston after the shot. And Nolisa must have said something as Winston misses the first. And free throw is still a huge issue for both teams. Sometimes I feel like those technical free throws are harder to hit when you're down there all alone.
Too easy. All by yourself. Second free throw is good. And yeah, we're not real sure what happened there. We didn't see anything physical happen, but it could have just been some jawing.
Must have been a magic work. There's a couple of them that result in immediate tees. And must have been one of those. As it looked like Winston made a little bit of contact after the shot. And when you're shooting this poorly, it can be easy just to lash out in frustration a little bit. Lady Lions do go up by 11 and keep the ball. Inside pass to Rodriguez. A little bit of fancy footwork and knocks down the jumper from just inside the three-point line. Moved her left foot inside without moving the right. Made the defense think she was going to try to drive. Instead, she relies on the long shot, which is really her bread and butter.
She has a good release. Very nice release. Offside, weak side rebound. And that's Moody battling in the paint against the trees of the Lions defense and able to negotiate that ball into the basket.
It's a good shot by Moody. She really was out of position when she got it. Picked the rebound further away than the basket and she stopped.
Dorsey inside the Hill. Nice pass. Monica Dorsey caught Hill cutting to the basket without ever stopping. She grabbed it and turned, spun, laid it off the rim. Are off the glass, Lions back up by 13 points. Guard to guard play, love it.
Foul inside here. It's going to come against Reeve.
Coming up in the second half of our doubleheader, it'll be the 19-3 Lions, number four team in the land, will put their perfect home record to the test against the Rams, Texas Wesleyan.
See here, just Charity Page playing strong inside, and just a little collision, enough to draw the foul. Both free throws are good from Nolisa. She had some struggles from the line in the first half. She was just 1-for-4, but she knocks down both there. 9 points on the game for Nolisa now.
Hill skips it over to Cox. Drives in the paint, bounce pass to Page. Back over to Hill. Into the paint, to the free throw line. Dorsey's turn. She hits the free throw line, rattles off the rim. Cox with an offensive board. Hill looking inside. She'll pull back out. She's got Rodriguez. Now here's Dorsey into the paint. Rejected in the middle. Credit, I think it's Nolisa, but got a piece of that one, Tim.
Looks like Dorsey was trying to get a pass off. High up off the glass, almost finds its way
almost
in
there. Went in, almost did. Rodriguez. Looking for Cox as Dorsey. Rodriguez back out top. Works left, loses the handle. The ball goes out of bounds in front of the Lions bench. And as that happens, Beatles points at McAfee. She'll check back into the game for Rodriguez.
McAfee had a very solid first half, 6 points. Got a steal in there, 4 total rebounds. Getting the start and doing a solid job in a half where offense was at a premium for both teams.
Nolisa, good move, but missed the basket.
Lady Lions will retain possession.
He's able to find the weak spot in that zone defense, Tim, and got a good look at the ball, or a good look at the basket. High release with the ball, but unable to put it down through, and Lions still up by 11 with 11:53 remaining. McAfee off the pick from Page. Dorsey. With now 10 on the shot clock, got to make something happen here. Hill with Cox. Stuck in the corner, 4 in the shot clock. Slides it over to Hill. Not a good shot. And Hill comes up with a loose ball with a fresh shot clock. Now Cox spins it back over to Hill. A lot of ball movement now. You gotta like to see this. Let's finish it off. Up ahead to Page. She puts it up and in. She sealed her defender. Called for it over the top. Dorsey saw it. Nice athletic move from Page to finish that off.
Created the straight line right down the middle there. Once she had that, there was really no way, as long as the pass was in a decent position. Just right through McAfee's hands, but she comes away with the rebound after nearly having the steal.
It's a very risky pass when you want to seal your defender and call for it up top, but it works almost all the time if the pass is good.
That's the key. The pass had to be in the right place. And luckily with Page, you can throw it up high. You don't have to worry about...
Here it comes again to Cox. Same move. She delivers. She says, I'll take some of that. And a timeout on the court as Coach Bill Freddy's seen enough.
The Lady Lions have equaled their largest lead of the game at 15 points. So just when the Lady Rams seem to catch a little bit of a break on offense, start trying to put some things together, it goes cold again. And now it's Lady Lions. So we see with some excellent
ball movement. Here's the first one. Look how she leans right and just calls for the ball. Here's the second one. She leans, she was opening up her right shoulders. Still the same result. Doesn't matter what side, you call for the ball up high, you seal with the front shoulder, call for it with the other shoulder. And again, two perfect passes to deliver that basket.
And both, again, relying on the height advantage you have right in there with Cassie Cox and Charity Page.
Great job by our camera crew today to capture all these highlights for us and have them ready to show our viewers. Thank you so much to our amazing student crew.
Nice to coach
the scenes.
Bill Franny. He's really starting to try to fire his girls back up. As the issue for them so far has been offense, but now defensively, the Lady Lions finding that inside seam. We saw it a couple times in a row with this. We saw the ball movement starting to pick up a little bit, resulting in a few turnovers, actually. but they have turned it into some successful scoring attempts the last few times down the court. And defensively, they're still playing very stout. Only allowed 10 points in this half, or rather 11 points in this half.
Threw that ball away.
Which, in this game, feels like a monumental amount, 11 points and a half. But in any other game, 11 points for the first 10 minutes of a half is just outstanding. And it's in 30 minutes now, the Lady Rams have only totaled 29 points.
Like you said earlier, they scored 80 against the Lions earlier. They averaged 69.8 a game, which is good for sixth in the Sooner. Right now, though, stuck at 29.
Nice pass inside to Cox. Can't get it to go. And a loose ball foul is going to come against Charity Page here. She hustled to try to get a hold of that bouncing orb. That is her third foul. So another Lady Lion in foul trouble now. McAfee with three, Winston with three, and Paige with three.
Paige leads all scorers on the floor for the Lions with eight. Bowl from the baseline, swish. Bowl, Caitlin Bowl, the junior from Albuquerque, cuts the lead back to 13.
She's been practically their only threat from outside the paint so far. Any other basket they've got has been a layup from point blank range.
Skip pass over to Hill. She finds Cox inside. Look what I found. I think she was quite expecting it, but it was a good pass from Hill. Cox unable to hit the short jumper.
Andy
here
Moody.
Come Lady Rams. Moody, yeah, over to
only
Lisa.
With 2 points on the game, she was your leading scorer the last time these two teams met. And the ball is dribbled out of bounds. Cooper trying to handle that one in. Just dribbled it onto the baseline. And
Cooper has 1 point, Tim. She averages nearly 12 a game. Here's Dorsey. Spots uphill. Cox looking for position inside. Cox wants that ball, and she's not happy she didn't get it. Dorsey now with nine on the shot clock over to Hill. Hill had already moved in a cutting fashion towards the baseline, and so Dorsey passes to nobody in particular. Hill will take a seat on the bench.
Winston will step back in with three fouls on the bench to try to prevent that. It would be a devastating foul. She has 13 points, leading the Lady Lions right now, leading all scorers. And the lead is 13 for the Lady Lions.
Nice inside pass. Too good inside pass. You're going to score almost every time you do that. If the Rams can start doing that, they will climb back into this in a hurry. That's one of the best offensive possessions they've had the entire game.
Probably the best. Go down low, back up top, back down low. The defense is completely out of position. That's just too easy.
Swish. McAfee. About 17, 18 feet away. Drains it.
She has 8 points now.
Moody for three. The push release three is good from downtown. Moody has cut the lead to 10 with 7:42 left remaining in the second half. And now Coach Beatles wants to call a timeout. It's going to be a full timeout.
This is familiar territory for the Lady Lions. When we were here last Saturday, they had a what seemed to be insurmountable 27-point lead against Southwestern Christian, ended up winning that game by two. The Eagles from Southwestern Christian stormed back into that one. This has been a problem for the Lions all year, finishing games off. Matter of fact, forget about this game. Just think to two nights ago. The Lady Lions were up by 7 points with around 7 minutes to go, had controlled the game for 33 minutes. Well, here we are right now, 7:40 to go, up by 10 points.
That was against USAO just two nights ago, right?
Yeah, against Science and Arts two nights ago. Science and Arts closed on a 9-0 run. The Lady Lions, like they did last time down, committed a bunch of turnovers, 7 turnovers in 7 minutes, did not score in the final 5 minutes of the game, and lost the game by two in the closing seconds. Coach Beatles knows that this is the exact same turning point as last game was, up by 10. You need to keep your offense working. And on defense, you can't relax. You can't just say, okay, we've done our job for the last 33 minutes. Let's just coast from here on out. You got to play 7 more minutes of aggressive basketball and try to come out with what would be a huge win here in the Sooner Conference.
Rams are tied for 6th, or Rams are in 6th. Lions tied for 8th. You need this win if you're the Lady Lions to basically climb back into a tie with Texas Wesleyan.
We mentioned 3 of their last 6 games are going to be against very tough opponents. That is going to take just unbelievable nights to find a way to knock them off. So you got to win this one if you want to go 4-3 to finish the year off. Block, but a foul, and that'll send Winston to the line.
A little nifty behind the back dribble as she drove down the left side of the lane, drew the contact, and she'll go to the line. Of course, all 4 of her Lions teammates drift down to the other end of the court, as is Beatles custom.
And that is the 5th foul against Toisha Cooper. She fouls out with 1 point, averages 11.6 points a game. And with 7:22 left, she picks up her 5th and final foul, will head to the bench. And that's not going to help her season average any.
The only starting senior on this ball club. That's more important as well. I mean, it's great that you shut her down, but you just lost what senior leadership you had. The starting senior leadership is gone on the bench with plenty of time left. So we'll see if Lady Rams can respond with their leader now saddled with 5 fouls.
1-for-2 from the line from Winston, and yeah, we see some aggressive play. The aggression is back on this Lady Lions defense. Short on shot, won't go, and Winston comes up with a loose ball.
She may take it herself. Finger roll. Dorsey negotiates the defender, the glass, and the rim, and lays it up and in. Lions back up by 13, under 7 to play.
Dorsey just in the right place, right time, and a travel called to turn the ball over. Dorsey, again, just right in the right place, right time. She's just 5'6". Finds a way to get a hold of that ball and put it in after the missed layup. Lady Lions ball, less than 7 remaining, up by 13. Game that started with 12 and a half minutes of no field goals for the Lady Rams. It took over 7 minutes to get their first point off of a free throw. Right now, the Lady Lions would love to close on a similar run.
Dorsey, again, delivers again, this time from the outside, from 14 feet out. A little off balance, but the true release was on the mark.
And back up by 15, long three-pointer, good. Lady Rams needed that. Liz Handy drains the 3 to cut the lead back to 12 with 6 minutes remaining. Big shot from Handy.
Huge. Keeping this close. Dorsey, not sure if she was looking for Winston or Page. Neither of them came up with the ball. Bowl now.
That's where you got to be careful.
In the corner,
quick,
inside.
Quick possessions and turnovers.
Nearly a travel from McCray. Here's a long shot. High rebound. Looks like it hit the...
Hit the shot clock, and that will turn the ball over. Dorsey will head to the bench, and Taylor Hill step back in, and Roberts will come in to play. As Page and Cox will go. Page and Cox are both heading towards the bench for a second there, but I don't think the Lady Lions want to play any 4-on-5 basketball, so Cox goes to the bench.
Look how fast Winston is.
Rich. Oh, just swatted away. McCray makes her pay for that one. Almost stolen away by...
Scrum for the ball. Let him play on. Here comes Winston again. 1-on-2. Spins to the left and loses the handle. Turns the ball over, trying to make something that probably wasn't going to be there. Amy Moody was just holding her ground.
And not a possession you need to have right now. You're up by 12, 5 minutes to go. You want to be able to run a little bit of clock and set up a good shot. You only held on the ball for about 3 seconds there and turned it over.
Now the Lions are going to give you that 3-point shot as they continue to stay packed in that 2-3 zone. They'll give it to them all night long.
And that'll
we'll
go off
it right
Taylor
here.
Hill's foot. Yeah, no, exactly. The Lions will give that to them. They've only knocked down 2 3-pointers on the game. So I think Coach Beals is willing to gamble on that. And offensively, and a foul, quick foul against Roberts. That's her 4th foul of the game. So Roberts has 4, Dorsey has 3, Page has 3, Winston has 3. not a game you want to see going to overtime for the Lions right now with four of your five players on the floor in foul trouble.
McCray works right, high off the glass, and a high rebound from Page. Under five to play here at the Schaefer Center. Lions still up. They lead this game by 12. Winston averages 18 points a game in the Sooner, near the top of the rankings. She's got 14. She wears number 14. We'll see if she can help take over this ball game. First, here's Hill inside to Roberts. Off the left side with the left hand, puts it up and in. Shakita Roberts with her sixth point. And now a steal from Roberts. On up ahead, Winston does get the handle, and she finger rolls it and gets the whistle, but not the hoop. She'll go to the line and try to shoot a couple. Great defensive play after a nice bucket from Roberts on the offensive side with a steal in the corner. Skipped it up ahead to Winston, who had to track it down. First free throw is good.
Yeah, they're up by 15 now. A chance to go up by their largest margin of the night.
Just again, watch this pass. Winston's like, wait, that's way ahead of me. I caught up with it. And then hacked on the up.
Just looking back at the Lady Rams season, with 8 minutes to go, their lowest point total of the year came in a loss to John Brown, 62-47. So
you're
still 4 minutes to go, but they're definitely not going to get anywhere close to the 80 that they put on the Lions earlier this year. Another
Roberts
turnover.
Was involved in that one again, Tim. Roberts causing havoc.
Yeah, she has been just clutch in this game. That ball goes out of bounds.
And all with four fouls right now.
Oh, yeah, she's still playing very aggressively. That's the benefit a big lead late gives you, is you can play with the same amount of intensity without the same level of fear. If you foul out, your team's still in a very good position to win this game. Hill almost loses that one, but keeps it in.
Hill just the one bucket on that cut to the basket about 4 or 5 minutes ago. She's got the ball now back over to Winston, turned the ball over. Looked like just too much velocity, or Winston wasn't ready for it.
And if you're the Lady Rams, this is pure desperation time. 3.5 minutes to go, you're down by 16, and you only have 39 points. You'd have to score almost half as many points as you scored all game in the next 3.5 minutes just to tie it.
That's how you do it, the three ball, and she, being
Nolisa
delivers.
She has 12 points on the game now. And the lead is cut to 13. So
that's how they're going to get back in the game, Tim. They've got to shoot threes and a lot of them and got to make them.
And this is big offensive possessions.
Because right now that 2-3 defense inside is not giving up much at all.
If I'm the Lady Rams, I'm considering a little hack-a-page strategy at this point.
Well, she's got the ball underneath. Over to Roberts, 8-footer. Good.
Nice look from Roberts. Backing away from the basket, gets her hands on the ball and drains it. Another three-pointer, that'll be off the mark.
And tipped away like she knew right where Winston was gonna be at. Winston drive the lane, lays it up and in with the right side. Boy, it's like Roberts and Winston are just on the same page without saying a word to each other.
They are just clicking right now on offense.
Don't foul.
And
she
Roberts
does foul,
does
she's
foul.
Gone. Roberts is gone, but like you said, with a 17-point lead, it's not the worst thing in the world. You prevented 2 points from going
exactly.
In.
Exactly. You prevented 2 free points. You took your fifth foul, and Roberts walks off with her hands on her head, but she leads with 8 points and, I believe, 4 blocks on the game.
And she scored half her points in about the last 90 seconds.
Yeah, really, what the Lady Lions did so well on defense, they've kind of flipped the script, and they've done so well on offense in the last few minutes. They have really been able to click, knock down shots, hit those running layups that they have trouble with so many times.
Not a bad foul, because she was going to score there.
Yeah.
She was making earn it from the stripe.
You are without Roberts for the rest of the game now. The lead is back to 15. So this critical offensive possessions as the Lady Rams will bring on the full court press. And Winston breaks it.
And now she'll spin back around and try to eat some clock.
Oh, absolutely. Now this is at the point up by 15. That 30 seconds and no points is a win.
Cox over to Page. What do you call it? A hack a page? Well, that's just what happened. McCray preventing Paige from the easy lane will send Charity to the charity stripe. Sorry, I had to say that at some point. You knew it was coming out. You knew I was going to just let it out there at some point.
Paige has struggled from the line. She hits the first, though, trying to ice this game up by 16.
She missed her first four free throws.
Knocks down
now
both of those.
Now she's on fire.
Back up by 17 points. 2 minutes remaining. And the Lady Lions, as a foul happens underneath on Winston, she asks what, but it's going to be her fourth. Lady Lions can really credit, as long as they hold on the next 2 minutes, it feels like they will. They can credit an unbelievable start on defense, in which they held the Lady Rams without a point for over 7.5 minutes and without a field goal for nearly 12 and a half minutes. Just unbelievable start on defense that gave them the opportunity to open up an early lead. But then all credit to the way they played on offense since then. The Lady Rams obviously have put up points, as you expect they would. Put up 28 here in this half. Standard what the Lady Lions would probably allow. And always a quick turnover. But the Lady Lions have kept it going on offense, and up until that moment right there and a few other exceptions have been very crisp, have not played mistake basketball. And a foul coming against Dorsey. That's going to be her four. So Winston and Dorsey both with four fouls.
I think it's McAfee.
Oh, you're right, McAfee.
So a win by the Lady Lions will push them to 6-8 in conference play. They'll be tied with these Lady Rams, will be 6-6.
Six and eight.
And so you've got two teams who are battling, along with several others, for that 6th, 7th, and 8th spot. Here it is again. And McAfee paid for that foul.
Yeah, two teams, they'll be tied, and since the Lady Rams won the first, and the Lady Lions should hold on to win this one.
The other team,
they'll be split with the season series, so
right.
It'll come down to tricky tiebreakers after that.
The other team in the mix is Southwestern Christian, who are presently tied with Lady Lions for 8th.
Three-pointer won't go, and
should they lose tonight, the Lions will take over 6th place alone in the conference. If I'm doing my math right.
Minute 29 to play in this one. A foul on the floor. And that'll send Cassie Cox to the line for the 1-1.
So, no 9-0 run tonight. Looks like the Lions are going to hold on and beat a tough Sooner Athletic Conference opponent, so they'll put that loss up in Chickasha behind them with this nice, solid home win here at the Shade.
And again, this is a win that kind of avenges one of your roughest losses of the year, 80-59. It was a loss that got away from you in the second half and really turned into an absolute blowout against a team you feel like you matched up well against. And so it is very big to go ahead and put that behind you and try to prove to yourself how much better of a team you are than you were back on January 9th, how much this team has evolved over the last month.
Travel
on the floor. That was Kayla McCray falling backwards, turns the ball back over. So a little bit of full court press from the Lady Rams, but they will not foul. The Lady Lions will just run the clock at this point as we approach 1 minute. As the Lady Lions will come away with a huge win, winning the way they like to, with defense, defense, defense. And then a few nice offensive plays on the inside later on in the game to get some clutch points.
Lions give up 60.5 a game tonight. They're going to give up probably just about 50, maybe 47 right now. Meanwhile, the Lady Rams yield 67.6 a game, and they're on par to do about just that, with the Lions having 63 points.
Well, the Lady Rams average almost 70 points a game, so at the moment being held 23 points below
their scoring
average.
That's the big stat, though. That's the big one.
Yeah, Lady Lions are scoring right where they usually do and scoring right where the Lady Rams usually allow.
22 points below their scoring average, and now under 40 seconds remaining.
And if the Lady Rams don't score in the next 34 seconds, they will equal their lowest point total of their Sooner Athletic Conference season which was 47 against John Brown, a top-ranked team.
How about this? You average, you give up 80 against this team last time you played them, and under 50 this time. Right now, that'd be a 43-point margin if the score remains the same. That is a huge compromise. I should say 33-point margin of difference for the Lady Lions.
Winston will pull it in. The teams will back off.
This will be it.
Shot clock is off, and Lady Lions will run the clock out to hold on for a 63-47 win. A solid home win to try to shake off a tough loss on Thursday and a tough loss early in the year against these Lady Rams, but that's your final.
And the crowd shows their appreciation. Your final, 63-47, game one of this doubleheader goes to the Lady Lions. Up next, the number four ranked Lions will take the field, will take the court against the Rams, a very familiar opponent. We'll be right back with some more stats and pregame information here in the SAGU Sports Network. Stay with us.
My ebbs and flows, so I wanna see you.